Rahul, I just want to confirm one last thing. You said so the most bit of the work with as an off counsel for a law firm, as you're saying, is advisory. Is that correct? Some of it you get independent briefs where you get to argue, and the other is advisory work primarily.
No, not at all. I
No,
mean, as an
no,
off
okay.
counsel, I pretty much do everything that I used to do as a full-time lawyer with AZB. It's
Yeah.
just that
The top level of it you do now.
I don't sit and take calls every 2 minutes from the clients anymore or have to respond to an email every
Okay.
2 seconds. But
Got it.
it's doing the same thing if it's litigation, going to the courts, fighting it out, briefing a
Got it.
senior. I do less of merger control now. I do one-off merger control where the lawyers or the AZB team thinks that I could step in, but
Okay.
that's what I do.
And a lot of three and four, is it?
Mostly three and four, the behavioral litigation and contentious merger control. So if there is a litigation stemming from merger control, then that's where I get involved. If we anticipate that there will be a litigation surrounding a certain deal, then I get involved.
So what do we call what how do we identify contentious merger control? Like there are some exemptions and then there are some regular filings
So
for
for example, you want to do the deal
yeah.
and you realize that it could benefit from an exemption. But when you look at the CCI's decision, you take a call that's not really clear. And usually, Indian law firms have advised the clients on the side of caution that if it's not clear, you go and file. But once in a while, you will have a client which will say, "Okay, sorry, guys, I don't agree with your view. I want to fight it out." So you wait. You wait for that notice from the CCI, which
Oh.
will come. Because they will read it in the newspapers that you have done a deal and you have not gone to them. They will send you a notice. It becomes contentious. It becomes it could get settled at that stage if you can convince them that yes, the decision to not notify was the right one. We've been successful in some of those. We have not been successful in some of those. And that's where the litigation starts if the client wants to fight that decision in the appellate tribunal.
So, what kinds of consequences have happened in case CCI later takes up and doesn't find the deal to be compliant with competition and says that you should have taken our permission or not done it?
So there are two parts to it. One is the simple substantive breach that you didn't notify when you ought to have notified to me. There, the CCI will slap you with a penalty.
Right.
It's the statutory maximum is an insane amount. It is, if I recall correct, the higher of 1% of the combined value of assets of the parties to the combination, or 1% of the turnover. So it could be a huge amount. It could be a company whose turnover, the combined turnover is $100 billion, and 1% could be $1 billion.
And this is also nullified.
Nullified meaning?
The acquisition or the combination is.
No, so that's the first part. The first part is that you didn't notify, and therefore I could
Okay.
potentially penalize you by X amount. And then they would say that you also must come and notify it to me. And on that notification, if the CCI thinks that this transaction could really be bad for competitive conditions in the market, then it could either suggest changes to the deal
Structural changes to the deal.
structure or suggest divestitures. Those are the two things that the CCI usually does. It hasn't till date blocked a single transaction, but it does have the power to block a transaction.
Yeah.